by natural gas, not by crude oil, which is cool in itself. So let's go to the demand side. They need to build these regasification facilities. Currently in Asia, there's over 40 of these regasification facilities planned or under construction today. In fact, in China, in Tianjin, they've built a regasification facility that currently is receiving no gas. It's just built, waiting for China to go out and find gas somewhere in the world, probably Northeast BC, to then ship gas to Tianjin so they can regasify it, liquid natural gas to Tianjin so they can liquefy it and use it in China. So there's over 40 facilities. Millions of dollars being spent on constructing these, and they all need to get the gas from somewhere. Qatar used to be the world leader in export of liquefied natural gas. Qatar also has the highest GDP per capita of any country in the world. The world's largest supplier, Qatar, has said in 2007, we are no longer going to supply any additional gas to the world markets. We've capped our production. And global natural gas is expected, demand is expected to double by 2030. So there are these Asian countries that are really looking to two places. One is Australia. Australia is widely expected to supersede Qatar as the global leader in natural gas exports in the next several years. And Canada is expected to take the place that Australia is really in today, which is second place in the export of liquid natural gas. And so why Canada? Why are they looking to Canada? Well, Canada and primarily the what we call the Montney Shale in northeastern BC has a lot of natural gas. So if you look at really what's happened in the oil and gas business in North America in the last 150 years, Texas is the largest hydrocarbon resource in North America. That was developed about starting 150 years ago, and they've really mostly tapped out the conventional plays there. Alberta is the next largest hydrocarbon resource in North America, the Alberta oil sands. They started developing that about 30 years ago, and they're well into that now. The Montney Basin, which is in northeast BC, is the third largest hydrocarbon resource. So now, it's just a natural progression. These oil and gas companies are now starting to develop the third largest hydrocarbon resource. And if you look at it on a shale standpoint, where you've got what's really been developed in the U.S. so far is the Barnett Shale was the first one they started developing. It's right here. This was the first shale. And now they're into the Bakken and the Marcellus Shale. Marcellus is a lot of oil. And if you look at the Montney, the Horn River, compared to that, they're way bigger. I mean, the Montney is almost five times the size of the Bakken and five times the size of the Barnett and three times the size of the Bakken and twice the size of the Marcellus. So you can see why these major oil and gas companies are attracted to northeastern BC because of the sheer size of the resource that we have available. It truly is a world-class resource, which is really cool. And as a result, these companies want to spend a lot of money in northeast BC. To date, it's about $60 billion that has been proposed. And the number that I find fascinating that I really care about is this little blue line here. Blue line on the graph. If this blue line on the graph is drilling, and drilling is in the shale gas business, drilling is constant. You consistently have to drill every single year. You need to drill new wells in the shale gas business to continue to get gas out of the ground. It's not like the conventional business where you drill one well and sit on it. You always need to be drilling new wells to get gas out of the ground in the shale gas business. So drilling, you see here, on average, over the course of the next several years up to 2028, is about $3.5 billion a year, $2 to $3 billion a year. In the short term, though, where we are right now, we're looking at almost $4 billion a year in drilling that's going to be spent in northeast BC. That's a massive amount of capital investment, and that money's already started to be spent. It already started to be spent, as you can see, in 2013, 2014. Moving now into 2015, they're going to spend that money again. So this gives you an idea. This is drilling, shale drilling in northeast BC in 2007. This is shale drilling today in northeast BC. So it's already ramped up substantially. And this is where we're going. So, you know, phenomenal amount of activity that's going to happen here in the next 10 to 15 years in the region. These are the undeveloped lands owned by the oil companies that are slated for development in northeast BC. So That drilling is going to create a lot of jobs. Direct natural gas jobs in Northeast BC between now and 2020 are expected to be a minimum of 20,000 jobs. That's direct jobs. For every direct job, you have between 5 and 7 spin-off jobs. The population of Northeast BC today is 64,000 people. So a ton of people are going to move there. And as a result, they expect the population will double, go from 64,000 people to over 120,000 people by 2020.
by renting out these units furnished. And I'll show you some numbers later.